Hello, I am Antastic and Fantastic, and today I'm going to be giving a small little health update because I'm having quite a few problems with my wrists. I actually have my left wrist brace and my right wrist brace, but I need to use my left hand to like touch stuff and I can't use a computer for this. But point of the matter, a little bit of a backstory. So when I was like around 19, 20, 21 range, I don't recall, quite a long time ago, I developed quite a few problems with my right wrist. I'm right-handed. I used to play badminton competitively. I was doing a lot of exercise. I was also stringing rackets for my job. So like lots of tedious finger work, and I was probably playing video games because video games are fantastic. So I developed lots of pain in my right wrist and probably like carpal tunnel or tendonitis, whatever you want to call it. I don't know. The medical professionals say just rest it, give it time, give it a break, rub it. Like the tendons itself along the wrist, I guess this one here, are lumpy. I press into here, I press there, that sort of idea. To no avail. So in my infinite genius back then, I decided, let's do everything with my left hand. So I started eating with my left hand, brushing my teeth with my left hand, using a mouse on the computer with my left hand. That's why I always have like symmetrical mice or mouses, because I like to use them with my left hand. I actually switch between both hands depending on what I do. But point of the matter is, after a couple of months of that, my left wrist started to hurt, then both wrists hurt, and then I was very frustrated. So basically, I just basically did nothing for that period of time with my wrists. I was still healthy in that regards. Like I didn't have my back neck problems yet. So I could like go for runs. I could play soccer, which inevitably led me to getting hurt in my back and neck. But fast forward today and I still have wrist problems. And they've been escalating since like early or late December, I should say. So it's been frustrating because right now I can't do much for my wrists. I can't type. I can't play games. I can't respond to comments. I can't write articles. I can't do much overall. And then I have all those problems with my back and neck, so I can't really walk, can't really stand. I can do my morning physio stuff, which I just did beforehand, but that's kind of it. So I'm starting to become closer and closer to like a little basket case, but thankfully there are things I can do. But in the interest of trying to like create more meaningful content, I think that what I could do is utilize, well, my voice. So what I propose for you, ladies and gentlemen, is we'll treat this kind of like the question time article I do on my website. Basically, post questions in the comment section, and ideally you ask why questions. If it's a question that can be Googled, it doesn't really achieve much. Like, ask me questions about pad or even like other stuff if you really want to, as long as it's not too weird or inappropriate. But ask questions, and then on Wednesday, so 2 days time from this video being published, I will go through that video like through here. I'm gonna orally reply, like, because the whole idea is like I don't want to use my wrist. Like, I haven't done basically anything for the past week. It's been incredibly frustrating. So I can answer those questions orally, which might be useful. But, and if anyone's curious of what I have been doing lately, well, I've been doing quite a bit of Spirit Island. I'd say Spirit Island is the best board game I have at this point in time, and I have lots of board games, and this is the expansion that came out recently. It is pretty fantastic. It's highly strategic. It's a board game I can play by myself, and I'm doing a Scotland tour. Basically, I've decided to play against Scotland level 6. I've played an excessive amount of Spirit Island, like well over 120, 150 games. I don't know. I've lost track. It's been several years since I've been playing Spirit Island. But basically, I'm going to play against Scotland, which is the highest level adversary. I'm going to use all 24 spirits over the course of 12 games. So no repeats, and I have to find pairings for certain ones to work. It's been quite fun. I think I am now two-thirds of the way through it, and I've managed to knock out all the weaker spirits. So now I feel like I have only the stronger ones left over. I played with Vengeance as a Burning Plague with Finder of Path Unseen last night, and it was fantastic. Great combination. In addition to that, I have been reading Dune. I read the first book. This is the second book. I read prior to that. I read Martian. I've read all the Hyperion Cantoses. And if you have any recommendations for great sci-fi or dystopic novels, leave them in the comments below. Because once I finish Dune, I think I'm going to go and read a couple more Philip K. Dick books. I have a couple of them on my shelf still. And then after that, I've kind of opened up, so to speak, in what I want to read. So it's just nice if you give me recommendations of what you have. But either way, let's treat this video as a question style one where I will answer it all around Wednesday, because it gives you time to comment and then gives me time to think about it if necessary. So to all you lovely ladies and gentlemen out there in the audience, hopefully all a fantastic day. I wish you all the best in your own pad adventures, and happy puzzling.